I'm just gonna set it up and then I'll be over there. Hold on. Do not attempt this at home.
Jesus, change your life.
Jesus, change your life.
Sign up real tight.
Jennifer Gregory reporting from the Royal High School mat room. Today we're going to take a look at how the varsity competition squad's preparing themselves for NCAA camp. So stay with me and we'll be ready in a sec.
Mr. Clement, how's your summer going?
Great. Flowers from Jennifer. What a nice gal. What a gal.
We're pinning in and we're pinning out.
Wait, I'm getting in.
Hold it.
Ready?
Jennifer.
One, two.
recording a little recording length on it.
Yeah, recording my
Yeah. Right over here. And now we have invite you to Gabby wherever you want for you.
We love you!
Bye. Thank you.
Turn the mic off.
Thank you. sleep, Omega. It goes something like this.
Thank you. will be Creighton Valley All-Stars JV. Thank you.
Thank you. very good.
Kim, you just lost another one.
Ah!
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Back at you.
She does, if you go like that.
Make sure you still do the things today that we have, okay?
Yeah, the pop and show.
Keep, make sure that you keep it in an L and you have the pop.
See, you're letting go of your elbow right here, left hand.
Gumby.
You let go of your elbows. Okay, here we go, now do it again.
You ready?
Keep going.
Keep going, all the snakes are listening.
Keep snaking. Remember the side snake.
Side snake. And make sure you go over with the shoulder first, then the rib cage, then the hip. Make it elongated. 1, 2, 3, 4, take 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Stop. Some of you do snap heads and some of you do lean heads. See what I mean? So some of you, yeah, see a little.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Stop. Do your diagonals. Okay. That was better. See? Now it's better.
They got the diagonal. Good.
Yeah. See, I do. It's diagonals, the hardest thing they hit. You know what I mean? So you guys need to work on those. Like, do that whole 8 count with the diagonal, and then stop and do it again, and stop and do it again. Here we go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Do it all again.
Do it again. You know, some of you are still doing this. It's supposed to be when you step out the side, it's straight up, there's no break. You don't go like this. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So this arm stays here.
Right. Yeah.
You wave in front. See, is it a diagonal or straight up?
It's supposed to stay in the diagonal and you wave in front of it.
Okay. Some of you are doing this. Here, here, pull it up. Like, all of a sudden, you straighten it out and pull it up. And it should be left here, right? See, and Chris, you let it dip too. So you went like that.
So keep your left arm fully still.
This is gonna be.
You guys
are doing this. Yeah. Yeah. And then you're doing a little one.
Narrow boxes.
So you're crossing the wrist or the forearm?
Wrist.
It's W-H-U-Y, it's here. And what's this? What's this? So you're like this.
Let's just make it like this because I'm always picking on
them for him. Yeah. It looks better as
farther
away from the head, I think.
Okay, keep that other hand farther away from the head. And make sure, you guys have to work on this kind of thing in front of a mirror to make sure your angles are the same on both arms.
I tighten up and I go like
this.
Thank you.
Number 4, Hanford High School! check for the winner. This trophy season passes to Magic Mountain. I will announce the number two team first. The number two team is Modern Day.
In this state. News Center 4's Rita Cohen has the story.
My victory means it or not.
The Arroyo High School cheerleading squad beat out 91 other squads from throughout California to win the state title. Proud coach Kim Hardester says the victory is especially sweet, considering half of the 18 members on the squad are freshmen and have never been in cheerleading before.
It is amazing because they are a novice squad. They've only been together 1 year, and they haven't had, like I said, any experience, really. But they just, every time I ask them to do something, they really try hard, and they keep working.
The girls pay $350 each for their own uniforms and bus money to games, and they pay their own way to travel and compete. Because all the girls couldn't afford it, they missed out on the national championships this year. But when they won the state title, they beat the team from L.A. that had won the national championship.
We said, or we'll say, get Arroyo, in our to win.
To celebrate their victory, the Arroyo High cheerleading team will get to perform at halftime at the Warriors game against Dallas on April 9th. In San Lorenzo, Rita Cohen, News Center 4.
Well, we have more news and Wayne Shannon coming up.
This is Christine. I'm at Arroyo High School. We got a cheerleading clinic going on here. And for my segment today, we're going to take a look at the state champs from Arroyo High School.
Overall, we're really good considering that we're missing one person.
Kim Hardester, the choreographer for the Arroyo High School competition squad.
It's a lot of fun, and I there's something inside me that likes to make up routines, and I see motions, and I see stunts and dancing, and I like to be able to express it. And this year I found a group of kids who can do that. They have a lot of talent. They're mostly very young, and they've been a real joy to work with the last couple of months. They really listen to me and cooperate, and that makes it fun. We have 18 girls, and of that, half are freshmen, and the majority of the rest are sophomores. We have one junior and one senior. They don't have any gymnastic training. We've taught them a little bit, but I really don't even know any gymnastics. We just kind of fake it. And a few of them have had some dance, but other than that, there is no formal training. I just teach them as they come in.
During the month of March, the competition squad went down to Magic Mountain in Los Angeles and brought home this trophy.
Nonstop!
Among them, they went down to Los Angeles to try and make the top 18. If they made the top 18, they would come back on March 14th to compete for the state championships. But they didn't make the top 18, so they thought.
We felt we did really good, and we got a lot of crowd response, but they didn't call our name. And so we went home very upset on Saturday because we thought, well, we didn't make it, even though we did our best. And on Monday, they called up and said that they had an error, and they wrote down the wrong school's name, so we got in after all. And we performed, and then we won, and it really made it even better.
What are your hopes for the future, Kim?
Well, I think next year is going to be an exceptional year, and it should be for a couple years because we have quite a few of the girls coming back.
Uh-huh.
We have 14 of the 18 that performed at state returning, and we have quite a few talented new people. I think that'll be there, too.
I'm at Arroyo High School on the football field where I used to be a cheerleader. I think the competition squad is pretty good. They're hopefully going to Florida next year where they'll compete for the national title. I think they'll do pretty good. I wish them the best of luck. I'm Christy DiZotti for Cutaway, and now back to Mike and Brett.
This is Dominique, as always, stepping out into the community. Today, we'll check out Daly City Talent on stage at Jefferson High. We'll roll over to Mission High for the latest in skateboard. But I like to jump right into it. And today's show, we're going to start off jumping with the California State Cheerleading Champions, the pride of Arroyo High in San Lorenzo.
Searching for some company. Feel the ring, dance with me. Then before blue seem out of place.
Other students at San Lorenzo's Arroyo High never imagined their own rally squad would make it to the top of the state championships this year.
I love it. I like it. I would like to have more. This is the biggest trophy we have, and that's just beautiful.
The competition was tough from Southern California teams, who usually take the top awards for the region. But Arroyo's unique Northern Cal style, the team's ability to pull together, and their confidence in themselves gave these cheerleaders the edge over the other squads. They hit that perfect beat.
When the curtains went up, it was like something that made us do better than we'd ever done. It was different, a lot different than any other place, because we knew it was the state. We knew that we could do it and show to our state that we could win, and to our school.
Searching for some company. Feel the ring, dance with me. Then before blue seem out of place.
This is the first year some of these cheerleaders have even trained, let alone competed. Membership is based on ability, not age, so you'll find freshmen and seniors working on routines side by side.
Well, first of all, you get to meet a lot of new people. It's a lot of fun. You become like a family. And it's like, for me, cheerleading, oh, I just love it.
I like the friendships, because almost all of our friendships come from the squad.
Five,
and sometimes
two, seven, eight. We
don't let the problems during cheerleading get in the way of our friendships, but a lot of really good friendships are built during cheerleading.
Arroyo! Better than ever! Straight to the top! We're headed for victory! Believe it or not!
Cheerleaders are sometimes seen as a cute diversion on the sidelines, just light entertainment between the quarters of a football or basketball game. But that's not how these cheerleaders see it.
People don't realize that cheerleading is a sport. They think football's a sport, basketball's a sport, but they don't realize cheerleading's a sport. It's like we practice just as long as them. Our season lasts a whole year, all year round. And during the summertime, we're practicing after school and weekends, whenever we get a chance.
It makes you work harder. It makes you know that you have to get your homework done because you have to go to practice. And so when you know that you have to do it and you have something to do, it makes you get your homework done.
Non-stop, we're climbing.
Self-discipline, success, and fun. That's what these spirit leaders will remember about their days on the team.
Last year was my first year, and things have changed a lot since then. And being here is kind of hard because I'm going to be leaving my squad. And I won't be able to do it anymore, and it's kind of sad. I wish I'd be able to come back.
Their last performance of the season was at a Warriors game where thousands cheered their winning combinations. So watch out for the Arroyo High School cheerleaders next year. They've started a tradition in San Lorenzo. Into the cheerleading scene, but these guys are too much. They put school spirit into the deadest students.
flavors with a tangy zip of Miracle Whip salad dressing. The bread spread makes anything on bread taste better.
Hamburger Miracle Whip.
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 Change mine to Miracle Whip.
Change yours to Miracle Whip.
Change mine to Miracle Whip.
The cleanser Rich uses to clean his baked-on, burnt-on grill is the same one Mrs. Ross relies on to gently clean her shiny stovetop. Now, what cleanser cleans that powerfully but without harsh scratching? Soft Scrub Liquid Cleanser with its unique mild abrasive formula. From Clorox, of course.
Three Guys Plumbing.
For clogs at their worst.
Oh, it's for you.
Liquid Plumber is the plumber to call first.
With us again tonight are the hottest new sounds of the year in the vocal group category. Delivering that sound first are the champions. They're students at San Jose State College, majoring in everything from industrial engineering to culinary arts. They formed this band to have fun. With two wins, let's enjoy the good time rock and roll of the Kingpins. Thank you, Kingpins. The Challengers got together in junior college, have been going strong ever since. From Seattle, Washington, here are 9-1-1.
So easily. All
Thank you, 911. Terrific sounds. Let's see who it's going to be. Champions, the Kingpins, receive 2 stars. Their challengers, 911, receive 2¾ stars. We have new champions. New champions. Okay, Lisa.
On Star Search, we're proud of our alumni. Every week, we'll bring you up to date on their success. Tonight, we salute Corey Maul. Corey was a semifinalist in the acting category.